Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we are going to take a look at LTX video 0.9.5. From the post, we can see that ComfyUI has added the support. It was actually a day one support. And it says here that it is lightning fast. It allows for multiple keyframe control. We have an improved quality and longer videos. Now, if you go down, we can see an example of what we can do. This is actually an example from the multiple key control where you are giving the model a start frame, an end frame, and then the model will interpolate between the two frames. And then we have this as the result. So as you can see, most of the video is actually static and it's only the part that is changing between the two frames which is being generated here. Now if we look at the highlights, it tells us that we have a commercial licensing which allows the use of this model for commercial purposes. We also have this new keyframe conditioning which allows this multiple keyframes. So control the start and end frames. Anything in between will get generated. You can also add in between frames and then the model is going to take care interpolating between these frames. It says here that we have an improved quality, a higher resolution video, support for longer sequences. There are fewer visual artifacts. And then the clip got an improvement, which resulted in better prompt understanding. Now they also mentioned that the generation speed got improved. So now it is faster. To get started with this version, you will first need to make sure that your ComfyUI is up to date. This is very important because the LTX video is actually a built-in feature inside of ComfyUI. It's not an external custom news that you will need to install from the manager. So if you are trying it, if you're loading any of the workflows below, and you find out that there are missing custom nodes, you will need to make sure that you are updating your ComfyUI. I will show you that during the installation process. If you are on the desktop ComfyUI version, then you can toggle the option for automatic update. Every time you restart the ComfyUI desktop version, it will update ComfyUI. The installation process is very easy. You need to make sure to download this model and then place it inside of ComfyUI models checkpoint. And then you have the T5 XXL. This one is the FP16. There's also the FP32 version. There's an FP8 as well. You can download anyone depending on the hardware that's available for you. And then you need to place it inside the ComfyUI models clip folder. And that's it. In terms of the workflow, the post already has it. By the way, I will leave a link to this entire post where you will get the download links as well. Now we have support for text to video. There's support for a simple image to video workflow. And then we have support for the multi-frame control. In today's video, we are going to take a look at these three workflows and test out, look at the demo and see if we have any improvement from the previous versions. Let's get started. All right, to update your ComfyUI, you'll need to go into the ComfyUI Windows Portable folder. If you have the portable folder, then go inside the update folder and then double click on update_ComfyUI.bat. After the update, you will see something like this that says press any key to continue. You can just press any key and that should close up the terminal or CMD command prompt. Then you just need to run your ComfyUI normally. Like I mentioned, if you have the ComfyUI desktop version, you can go into the settings and enable automatic updates, and it's going to take care of updating ComfyUI as well as the dependencies. If you have a manual installation of ComfyUI, then you will need to activate your ComfyUI virtual environment and then go into the project directory. You can do CD and then change directory into your ComfyUI project directory. By the way, the project directory is this folder here. So once you are in this inside the terminal, then you will type in git pull and then pull the latest version. Okay, so I've installed the updates and now I'm here. Next, you will need to download the model. and then place it inside ComfyUI models and then checkpoints. You will see here I have the version 0.9.1 as well as this new version 0.9.5. So it will have to be inside the checkpoints folder. For the clip, I've chose to go with the FP8 version. If you have additional VRAM, you can go with the FP16 or FP32 version. The clip will go inside our ComfyUI models and then the clip folder. Let's start with the text to video workflow. Click on the link, it will automatically download the .json file, it's the workflow file. If it does not automatically download and instead open it directly in your browser like mine, you can right click on the page and then select save as. This will take you to your save as dialog box, and then you can type in a name and then make sure that the extension is .json. Now while saving, make sure that it says here JSON file as the save as type. Otherwise, if this is anything else, let's say it's all files, in the name section here, the name box, make sure that you are adding the .json yourself. Now, once that workflow is saved correctly, then go into workflow, open, just navigate to where you have that .json file saved, double click on it to open it. Like I mentioned, if you get any red node or if the workflow doesn't load correctly, you need to make sure that your ComfyUI is up to date. Now let's go into this load clip here. We'll need to change this to the version that you've downloaded. Mine is the FP8 version. And then the load checkpoint here, you'll need to make sure that you're selecting the 0.9.51. If by any chance when you click on the drop down, you do not see the models that you've downloaded, then it means that you place the model in the wrong folder. Just go back, make sure that the model is in the checkpoint folder and then the clip is in the clip folder. Now I'm going to keep this the same and leave everything as default and click on the cue prompt. It's completed. And as you can see, this is the result from the text to video workflow. And looking at it, it's quite good. The house can use a little bit of work, but otherwise it's actually very good. Next, let's load the image to image workflow. Now, as a tip, if you cannot download the .json file from the post, you can go into workflow, click on browse templates, and the ComfyUI developers have added the support for LTX video right there. So just click on the video category here, and then you will see the text to video workflow here. We have the image to video workflow here. And then you can scroll over, you will see other video generation workflow. Click on the image to video workflow and again, change the clip, change the checkpoint. You can change the prompt if you want to. I'm going to leave it as it is. And this one says that we want a tracking shot of a beautiful scene of the sea, well, waves on the beach. And then we have an explosion in the water. So remember that this load image is going to be the start frame. So you will need to put something that is relevant to your prompt from here. So I'm going to use this generic image of a beach as my input image. But as you can see here, this resolution does not match the video resolution. So we'll need to add a node to resize it here. I'm going to use the resize image from the KJ nodes. You can install it from the manager. If you have any other nodes that can resize an image, you can also use that. By the way, you can even use the upscale image one and change the crop to center and then just place the width and height in here. I'm also using the upscale method LensZoss. Now this image will have to go into the LTX video to image as this node here, this input right here. And then it's just a matter of generating the image. And here is the result. Now we can see the water is moving. We have some movement. We have some movement in the trees as well as the sky, but we don't have the massive explosion in the water that was mentioned here. This is pretty much similar to 0.9.1 model, where whenever we have multiple action scene that is happening in the shot, it's not able to complete everything. Now, the last one is the multiple control one. If you go into browse templates video, it's not available here, so you will need to download it from the post. So in the post here, scroll down until you see this one and then click on image to video workflow. Then go into workflow, open, find the workflow and then select it, click on open and you should see it like this. This workflow is pretty much similar to the LTX image to video workflow. The only thing that we have is this bottom section here where we have an LTX pre-process which goes into the add guide, and this one allows us to chain it multiple times depending on how many frames that you want to provide to the model. So right now with just one add guide we are using a start frame, but let's say at frame 10 you want to add a second image, then you can chain these two together and in here you will put in 9. So remember that this will be an index base. So we start from frame 0 and frame number 10 will be the index 9. Now, if you want to do the last frame, you want to go from first to last, then you can change this number to minus 1. Minus 1 will be the last frame. So you don't have to restrict yourself with just having one add guide. As long as you have the individual frames, you can have one at frame index 9. We can have another one here, and let's say this one is going to be 20, this one is going to be 30, and you can keep on chaining them like this. And finally, this output will get passed to the sampler custom here. So you just need to connect the positive, negative, and then the latent here. So I'm going to just do start and then end. Now we already have a node here that you can activate by pressing Control B on your keyboard if you do not see this. However, if you do see this, the moment you click on it, you can press on this icon here and that's going to do the same thing. Now as you can see, this one is already set up to be the end frame. So minus 1 is end frame. So I'm going to go from this where the character has her eyes open and this one she's kind of nodding where the head is tilted down and then the eyes are closed. Enter a positive prompt based on the input image that you have, and that's pretty much it. You just need to have the input image, change the prompt. Make sure that your clip is correct and then the checkpoint as well is correct. Everything else is pretty good. Then we can click on the cue prompt. Okay, it's completed. I made 2 changes since I did not realize that my input image was the incorrect size. So I've added a resize node just to resize it and crop it to this resolution. I've done the same thing for the second image, and to better understand what is happening here, I've added a preview image here. So let's take a look at the result. This is the result here. There are artifacts. Now they did mention that this model reduces the visual artifacts, but it does not completely eliminate the visual artifacts. So we still have the same issue as the previous version. It should be less though. Now let's try to understand what is happening here. So this is my input images. The top one is going to be the start frame. So as you can see here, the first one is this image, and if I go down here, the last image here is this one. So this is what is happening with this section here. When we say that the LTX add guide with the frame index 0 is going to take that image as the first frame, and then if you put it as minus 1 it's going to be the end frame, and then the model is going to be responsible to generate everything in between these two frames. Now like mentioned, you can have additional add guide different multiple keys, and these are going to be the frames in between. So if I had more of these I could have added one to guide the model from, let's say, this first one until here. And then if I had another one, I could guide it from this one until here, and then from this one until here. You can chain these add guides and then let the model generate the missing frame that are in between them. So that's pretty much all that we have for this new version of the 0.9.5. Now, in terms of generation speed, let's go into the terminal. You can see that it's around 30 seconds for the text to video, about 35 seconds for a simple image to image, and it's around 40 seconds when we add more images to it. So if I were to add 3 input images, then this time will go up. All right, so thank you for watching until the very end. This was the LTX video 0.9.5. I hope this video gave you an idea of what you can expect from this model, and let's hope that we get more improvements in the future. Thank you once again for watching. Have a nice day. Take care. I will see you next time.